Welcome to the Farming Your Career podcast with host Dr. Aaron L. Albert, where we explore a variety of healthcare and pharmacy-related topics, including career development, healthcare IT, informatics, innovation, entrepreneurship, STEM, women's issues, and more. Farming Your Career podcast is part of the Pharmacy Podcast Network, and Aaron has had the number one most downloaded episodes of 2016 and 2017 of the entire Pharmacy Podcast Network. Now, here's your host, Dr. Aaron L. Albert.
I'm Fiona Sartori-Taverna. My company is Sartori-Taverna Design Pharmacy, and you are listening to the Pharmacy Podcast.
Welcome to the Pharmacy Podcast. I'm your co-host in 2018, focused on your career development, Aaron Albert. And we've moved. Our new title of our channel on the Pharmacy Podcast Network is Farming Your Careers. Today, we have a very interesting discussion, part one of a two-part mini-series that we're focused on around design thinking in pharmacy. Design thinking is a very hot topic across the world of art and architecture. However, it's now starting to permeate all professions, including pharmacy and healthcare. And I think, personally, we need a lot more design thinkers within pharmacy and healthcare as well. So part one today is going to focus on a gal I actually found over at LinkedIn. Her name is Fiona Sartori-Taverna, and she is with Sartori-Taverna as her firm. And it's an architectural firm that has designed pharmacies in 28 different countries around the world. So Fiona shares her passion with us on design and good design and why it's important in pharmacy practice. I'll be back at the end of the episode to talk a little bit more about part two of this mini series coming soon. So Fiona, thank you for being part of the Pharmacy Podcast.
Thank you so much. I'm very happy to be with you today.
Yeah, and I'm so glad that LinkedIn actually brought us together because I saw some of your work, your design work in pharmacies online, and I wanted to get you on the podcast because I'm personally fascinated with design these days when it comes to not only pharmacy, the physical pharmacy, but in terms of wellness and having patients have their best lives. But we're going to talk a little bit more with you about your own design in pharmacy today. But before we get into that, let's just start with, how did you get to where you are today in terms of your career, Fiona?
Erin, this is a family story because everything started, with my grandfather that was born in USA and from an Italian family, of course. But when he decided to come back in Italy, he moved up north in Turin, and he started to work for Adriano Olivetti. Maybe everybody remember the typewriters. It was a very famous Italian company at the time. And so my grandfather, Giovanni, he decided to bring into the Italian market the pharma metallic drawers. He was the first one to have this idea. From this, my father, Guido Sartori-Taverna, I started to work with him, and they started to specialize only in pharmacy. So my company was founded in 1965. And from then, my father understood immediately the importance to work in this niche, in the pharmacy niche in Italy. And he started to develop and design innovative fixture lines. And so in this moment, he created the Sartori-Taverna, the company that me and my brother, that we both are architects, are on right now. My father is still on, he's the president, so he's with us. And so me and my brother, we are the third generation of the family that do this job. And this, of course, you understand it's a lot of history. We have experience and, of course, know-how through the years in Italy, but also worldwide, because we work really everywhere. And our first pharmacy outside was in Hamburg, in Germany, in the 1965. How we start to work abroad, it was that many different pioneers, pharmacists around the globe started to find us in internet, and we started to travel and to go to visit them, realize their pharmacy, and so let me tell you, I traveled a lot in the last years, and I acquire a lot of data as experience only in pharmacy. Every time, in fact, also now when I visit a city, the first things I do is visit all the pharmacy in town. And so some clients call me workaholic, but I think it's only because I really love what I do, I like, and I'm very, very curious.
Yeah, I love that you have a family kind of entrepreneurial story there as well, Fiona. That's fantastic. So, other than your family's influence in a family business, did you always know that you were going to become an architect and work in the design firm that your family founded? Or was it something that grew over time for you as a passion?
Alla, in the beginning, was not like this. In fact, after my degree in architecture, I came in USA, where I stayed 3 years, and I worked for many different architectural firms as landscape also, because in Italy there was before just one degree. But then I came back in Italy and I started to work with the company because of my knowledge of the language and the market. And you know, maybe because I was happy. When I was little, our office was in my home. And so I have a pharmacist everywhere coming all the time. So it's, I think the evolution of the pharmacy is part of our own history. And I really love my job. It has been a progress. You know, more I was involved, more I understand the needs of the pharmacy, more I like it. And I think that I also put all my creativity in this because I'm a very creative person. So it's a family business, but I hope one day one of my daughter will be the fourth generation.
Oh, that would be fantastic. So what do you think, Fiona, are the unique challenges in designing a pharmacy? You mentioned earlier that your family's business kind of has focused on pharmacies now specifically. So what are the unique challenges in designing a pharmacy these days?
Yes, there are a lot of challenges. And I think our challenge is the wellness first. The wellness is to create a space for the pharmacy that are intended in the sense to give wellness to the customer, no? Not a sick place, not a sad, dark place, but a place where there is a serene atmosphere, I quite relax. And also a challenge is to create space that are super functional for the pharmacist. So the staff and the pharmacist can work in a better way and also quicker. The today challenges, I think, is to obtain smiles from the pharmacist and smiles from the patient. To do this, we need to work and try to satisfy at the best.
So why should pharmacies consider bringing in your particular type of architectural firm that has expertise in pharmacy? What is it about design other than the wellness aspect and, you know, making customers happy? Should pharmacists consider specifically with design thinking, which is, seems to be a huge trend right now as well?
Yeah, sure. The design is very important for the pharmacy because give a lot of benefits to the pharmacist and their customer. Optimization of the space, for example, visibility from the outside and better communication with an interior graphic very well studied. It's very important today to create a well-designed pharmacy because we want that the image of the pharmacy is professional, not commercial. Like most of the time is right now, and in USA I see that what is the most important right now is the marketing. But in truth, we need to come back to think not only about products, but to the people. The people want these. People want to feel that you solve, that you give a solution to their needs. And so pharmacy well design, where inside you put consultation space for advice, for a special consultant that can come in appointment. We are doing a lot of job in this sense. And the space also, for example, for kids, like a picture I think you saw in LinkedIn and make us meet each other.
Was yeah.
An Italian pharmacy, very centered, customer-centric, and centered in the family. So a huge space for kids that can come in the pharmacy and have a moment to play. Meanwhile, the parents, of course, are more free to shopping around, rouse around. Why? Because the market is changed. The things that my company follow the market worldwide in so many years give always how the market is in each country we work, no? The event of the sales online like Amazon or other big company keep the people a little bit lazy. So you need to concentrate their attention and to push them to go outside the home and find the community pharmacy downstairs near local to you that offer a smile, a very good customer service, that have space for kids or space, for example, I don't know, natural food, bio-organic, and some tasting table on which you can try the product and have the advice of your pharmacy. These are the things that keep the atmosphere very attractive and also let the people stay more, shopping more, be relaxed, feel cozy, like at home, but with the technology and the advice. So I think in day-to-day world, coming back to your question, it's very important to concentrate in the health and prevention of the customer. Try to give them the best solution to their needs.
So, Fiona, you also talked online about the power of storytelling and how that relates to design. So let's say hypothetically, I'm going to start a pharmacy tomorrow and I've hired you, if I was lucky enough to do that. What's the first thing that you would do in working with a pharmacist owner or an owner of a pharmacy when building the design of that pharmacy?
Yeah, sure. First of all, we are not so expensive.
Okay, good to know.
So, no, first things, what drive me is always the passion for this work. So for me, it's a pleasure to help pharmacists. You can ask also in LinkedIn, everybody that call me or write me, I always answer to everybody if I'm serious. But anyway, if you are a pharmacy and call me, the first things I do, I will make a lot of questions to you because America is very large, so each community is different. So I'm working right now from California to Florida to New Jersey, Texas, Wisconsin. So, and already inside the states, there are many different village, community, and situation. So the first thing is a lot of questions to understand the situation. If it's possible, I come on site, of course, and I do my own analysis. But the first thing that is important is to understand your reality. As a pharmacist, you know your community, you know your people. But of course, I can give you the tools for understand what is around you, no? So for the first question is, take a look at what are your competitors. Do you have a chain near you? You have a powerful or historical independent pharmacy? And then, of course, I will ask, what is your goal? So why you want to do your job? Many times, many months ago, it happened to me, and I wrote an article on this. I make this guy, this pharmacist, American pharmacist, wrote this article about what drives a pharmacist to become a pharmacy, no? From working for a chain and give up and open your own independent pharmacy. Well, I think first of all it's a passion for the community, give the right advice and be sure to have the time to talk with the elder lady and have a smile for the kids. So many of the clients I have, this is their goal. And second, in what way you want your pharmacy? Because it's true that I will design with my creativity, my experience, your pharmacy, but it will be your second home, no? That most of us, our workplace is our home in the nowadays. And so I try to tailorize all the question and all the work I do. It's not only a copy and paste, no, at all. Every pharmacy is unique because it's very important to position also the pharmacy in the market in a different way. So I cannot design the same pharmacy I'm doing in California, in Texas, because people, patient, and customer are different. And so this is what is behind all the research. And when we design the graphic for the interior of a pharmacy, we check the territory, no? So if there is a lake, the lake will be a protagonist inside the pharmacy in some way, something that the people feel very comfort or they are proud. For example, I'm a designer of pharmacy in New Jersey, in Burlington, and the client told me that the community loved the bridge there. I take a look and for me, doesn't inspire message, but I'm sure that for the community I have a history for this. And so we introduce image of this bridge inside the pharmacy. Oh, so a cool. Lot of questions.
That's awesome.
Forgive the right answer also, no? Because I want that we try to create a success pharmacy, and a good starting analysis is what is the best first step to do. Then to have a right survey, because if it's not precise, and we are very precise in my company, we can't do a very good architectural job. And you know, most of the time my clients are not just clients for me, are became like a family, like a community. This is what we always try to do. Consider that, for example, the client we have in Italy are generation of pharmacist family. So the pharmacy that my father did or my grandfather did, and now we are doing the the nephew, the son, the daughters. And sometimes it's nice to have this kind of, because it's a team, no? A one-to-one.
Yeah, I love that. More family you've got in here, and I love that. So, Fiona, you talked about some of the United States areas that you are designing pharmacies in. Where have you designed other pharmacies globally, and do you have a favorite?
Okay, right now we reach 28 different countries in the world and 4 continents. And so everywhere, practically, because we did the pharmacy in Russia, in Hong Kong, in all the Middle East. In the last 7 years, I travel up and forth for Saudi Arabia, that, as you know, is not so easy for women also. Mm-hmm. But with a great success, we have a dozen of pharmacies. In fact, in less than 2 weeks, I will be in Dubai for the Arab Belt. We design in all of Europe, of course. And in America, we started in the 2005. The first pharmacy in America was in New Jersey. It's called in Marlboro, New Jersey. And you say, what is my favorite? My favorite is the one that I will design tomorrow, because for me it's a challenge. So I want always to do better, best. And so I'm very ambitious in this.
So what's your favorite parts about designing a pharmacy? Is it the research stage? Is it the analysis stage? Is it the actual drawing and the mock-up of the design? What is it for you that's your favorite part of designing pharmacies?
My favorite part is the creative part. So when I have all the elements and data that we pick up, and we put all together, because this work is not anymore only to design architecture, interior design, but it's a mix of many, many different factors. We study, for example, the category, so the product and how they have to be divided in the pathway inside the pharmacy. And for do this, you don't want to create a boring old gondolas store like we see in the drugstore chain, no? So we try to always to come out with attractive pop-up attention point, so focal point. This focal point have to be artistic. And so this is the part I love. This artistic point that change all the time. I told you we connect with the territory, so we want to telling a story, the story of the territory where there is the pharmacy, or sometimes if the pharmacy itself have a history, we want to tell this, because the patient that come inside the pharmacy can be also elder people that remember some past times that now are gone. And maybe it's nice to remember this to the new generation. I like to mix up a lot, and we have this new concept we call a digital pharmacy. So a pharmacy that is technological, so we took all the innovative material, technology, beacons inside our fixture, particular material that are very resistant but very nice look, with the warm of the physic touch, so to wake up the 5 senses of the people, no? With a perfume, with a light that attract, with a smell. In Italy, we start to create, and also I'm doing a pharmacy in Dallas, okay. Like this, with a kind of a bar kitchen where there is some cooking show, and in the pharmacy you can go for an aperitif or can be a dinner with for diabetics with a recipe for them. So the creative process is what I like, really, really like.
And, you know, what caught my eye about your design, Fiona, was the pharmacy with the tree in it. Can you explain how the tree got into the pharmacy and how that local story, I guess, or how did you even get a tree in a pharmacy, I guess is my question.
Yeah, sure. I told you artistic, but sometimes to put art in the pharmacy have a hidden meaning behind. The first tree like that you see, and you can see also in Austin, because there is one of our pharmacy that have this kind of wood tree, born because we have a pharmacy with a huge pillar that was really in the middle of everything. So we have this idea to hidden the structure of this pillar with something beautiful. This was in north of Italy, Farmacia Franzoni, if I remember well, and it was a big success because, you know, this became the pharmacy of the tree.
Yeah.
And so all the people go there only because they recognize the tree, and of course, Christmas time was adorned and everything. So it's made by Italian sculpture that change with our design and dimension that we have. So sometimes we use tricks. Now, if we have a small pharmacy, we have a lot of tricks using a color or mirror or different other things to keep the space open. And so art help this absolutely.
Oh, I love the tree pharmacy. I love the story where there's just, you know, this architectural barrier and you actually make it an asset. And now people come to the pharmacy just to see the tree, which I think is phenomenal.
Yeah, because my father always tell me that if you have a huge structure inside the pharmacy, you need to build a bigger, more structure, and so you can hidden this. So happens sometimes, you know, in Italy we are full of village and pharmacy with the enormous old ancient wall and pillar and vaults. So you need to be very creative for try to find the solution that keep the space functional, optimized, but very beautiful and easy to use by the customers.
So Fiona, your work is very visual. So where can people learn more about you and your firm and your designs online and offline?
Yeah, we have a website, www.sartorettoverna.com, and soon the American part will be totally renovated, so you will come there. And of course, we are in all the social. You can find the LinkedIn, like you find us, in Facebook, in Instagram. We are almost everywhere. But if you want, for example, to see me in person in the USA, I will participate next March in Nashville. There will be the annual convention for APHA. Mm-hmm. So I will be there with a booth because during the year we do a lot of fair. So if someone can come, want to come to visit us or just to say hi or show me the pharmacy plan, I will be there with some of my architect.
Well, very exciting. Maybe I'll have to come to APHA just so I can meet you, Fiona.
Yeah. Sure, absolutely. You have to. My goal is to change the American pharmacy market because it's too much commercial. We want a professional American pharmacy. We want the pharmacy recognize like the value that he has and he had in the past. So I'm working a lot for also from my side to push this idea Less product, more smiles.
I love
so
that.
So a welcome place to smile. These have to be the pharmacy today.
Yes, and you wrote a post about commercial pharmacies versus professional pharmacies. So we will definitely link that up in show notes so people can read more about that. So with that, Fiona, are you ready for our speed round?
Yes, I am.
Okay. All right. What books are you reading right now?
Usually I read the always two book, not one. So the 10 principles behind great customer experience of Matt Watkins, and a very cool book that is called Why Fonts Matter of Sarah Hindman.
What podcasts are you listening to?
About Italian podcaster a lot, but one of course that I like is Business Caffeine, and I really like also one yours, of course, and I really like one American that I follow all the time that is called The Ultimate Entrepreneur by Dan Kennedy.
How are you planning ahead for this new year?
Well, I'm writing a book, so to have a time to finish my book and to start the Capsula International, so the lab that we already started from 2 years in Italy, here in our headquarters. It's a pharmacy lab for our foreign clients where to discuss and exchange ideas between owners of pharmacists or pharmacists. Meanwhile, the Italian Capsula is held at most of the time in our headquarters. I would like that Capsula International will be wandering around the globe. So like in a music tour, I will bring around our vision of the professional pharmacy.
I hope this. Love that. So you're in Italy, and so we always want to know about the healthcare system there locally. So what's your one word to describe the Italian healthcare system?
Free.
Wow. Love that word.
And I don't say anything else.
And what's the best career advice you ever received?
To fight for my goal and never give up. I think this is very important. Also, when you think that you have a period down or everything is dark, you have to find the strength in yourself. So never give up to your thinking, to your thoughts, and fight for your goal.
Love that. Well, Fiona Sartoretto Verna, how did I do on your name?
Perfect. Okay. I'm awaiting you here in Italy.
Well, thank you so much for being part of the Pharmacy Podcast. I love this conversation with you. It was not something we normally talk about in pharmacy. So thank you for sharing your expertise with us today.
You're welcome. I'm very happy to be here with all of you.
Thanks for listening to another episode of Farming Your Career. Our two-part episode, our next episode in this Design Thinking in Pharmacy mini-series, focuses on Cardinal Health and a division they have called Fuse that uses and employs design thinking to solve real-world problems in pharmacy. So we're excited to go share and talk more about design thinking as a process and how it can be used in pharmacy practice. My name is Erin Albert. You can follow me over at Twitter at Erin L. Albert. Of course, you can always follow us at Pharmacy Podcast. And now we have our own channels on Twitter and Facebook as well. So just type in Farming Careers and we should pop up. So please join us there for the conversation. Until next time, take care.
Thank you for listening to another episode of the Farming Your Career Podcast, part of the Pharmacy Podcast Network. If you have ideas or comments for Erin, be sure to contact her through Twitter. Follow her at Erin L. Albert. And remember to keep your career growing.